So, this is the game of Brick&Putt. Brick&Putt is played with two players or teams. You have 12 balls, and it's nice to have each team or player have their own color. So, once your balls are out there on the course, you can count your score easier. If they were all white balls, then how would you know which ball is yours, right? So, if you go down here, you can see the point regions. After we putt 12 balls, any balls that lie in here are worth 1, 3, 6, and 5. And you count your score after all 12 balls are putted. So I'm going to go ahead and start with white. And of course I want to load up as many 6s as possible, but that's easier said than done. Let's see what I got. Oh, that's 3. It's 3-0 if we were going to stop right now. I'll just kind of go quickly through it. That's a 6. So that's the best putt you can do is a 6. White's turn. Let's see if you can. That's probably off the course. 0 points, of course. Yellow's up. Go for the 5. But I'll take a 3. White's up. Oh, I pushed yellow in. So that happens. You might push your opponent in, which is good for them. I'm going for a 5. And it's off the course. White's up. I still want that 5. For some reason, that 5's hard to get. 6 is better. Yellow's up, going for a 5 just because I can't get the 5. And I'll take another 6. White's up. I'll go for the 6. Maybe I'll get a 5. And it's off the course. Yellow's up. Going for the 6 again. And 6. So we're loading up that 6. It doesn't, as long as the ball is at least halfway over the cylinder, it counts for a 6. White's up, and I could probably sneak one more in the 6, but I'm going to go for that 5 because I can't get it. And I'll take another 6. Yellow's up. Last putt. And you might want to count, see, right now, since the game's to play to 25 points or higher after a round is complete, so there's 24 points sitting in the 6. So. Yellow, all yellow needs to do to close out this game is really get 1 point, or hit it in any point in the region. Because white's only got, 12 points plus the 6? So yellow is the clear winner, unless I happen to knock all the whites in and me off. So that's game over. Oh, it could roll back. So if this would have rolled back, we would have to play another round because yellow would only have 24 points. But I did get the 1. That's 25, so that's game over. Most of the games you play multiple rounds because you don't get that many 6s, but it depends. A lot of guys, if they're good, they'll just load up the 6. But it all depends. Sometimes you'll get a slope and then you have to... count for the slope and kind of aim to the right or left depending on the slope. That's a simple game of Brick&Putt right there. And basically what you need is 12 feet of area to lie the game out. And what the game comes with is 12 balls plus two other balls that go along with a certain game called Moneyball. So all these balls come with it, and then there's 2 rule books that you can download off of www.brickandputt.com. It also comes with these shims, because whenever you're playing, sometimes all floors and surfaces aren't level. So if this, for instance, I can put the shim here in case the ball wants to go to the right, or I can put the shim, you know, anywhere you feel that you need to. Quite often you need to put it under here for the transition. That's where I usually put them. And they just fit in real easy like that. And Again, it's 12 feet long by 18 inches wide. And sometimes if you don't have that long of an area, all you have to do is kind of fold this up and play that way. That's easy. Sometimes I've seen people cut it, if you need to cut it for your living room or whatever. That's fine too.